budget speech. The content of the budget speech is inconsistent with the details of the budget.
When the budget was read,
the president presented a budget, he read a speech, and by the time the 1,800-page document, which I got about 2 days later, got onto the table of the legislators, they discovered that under different budget heads and subheads, things are not adding up together. So became accountants.
All right. Let me say this. And I think that when you introduced him, you talked about his qualification as an accountant or someone who has knowledge in budgeting. And I said this with the greatest sense of respect, that the responsibilities of the National Assembly is to do checks and balances. Mm. And fundamentally, you don't expect them not to look at the figures and the details. That's point number one. And point number two, the president wasn't supposed to read the whole details of a budget.
No.
He was supposed to present a speech, and that was what he did, introducing the policy thrust of his regime. He did simply that. I think that almost always, like my mentor, my intellectual mentor would say, he says, oh, what a tangled web we weave when first we practice to deceive. Almost always, when we talk about this regime, because we're too anxious for, and that was why the Minister of State for Petroleum used the word magic. You want a regime that was sworn in May to present her budget before December? Oh, what a tangled web we weave. And then you want a regime that was sworn in May to suddenly put the figures and the data together like what other regimes before it could not do. I think that fundamentally what we must do is be factual and benevolent to the fact that this regime is committed first to economic and financial rectitude, accountability in leadership, and a new paradigm and practice in governance. And that's exactly what we have. That is why, like I said, for the first time in the history in this democracy since 1999, you have a budget that was thrown down by 17 billion. For the first time in this democracy, you have a president who is explaining fundamentally to the Nigerian people and taking responsibility for whatever happened. That is, as you and I talk, Neta, you are aware that persons in the budget office have been redeployed, some sacked. That is the change mantra. A new order, a new paradigm, a new dispensation is on our hands. Mm. And I think that fundamentally, before you criticize, you put issues in proper perspective. I will do facts and figures rather than sentiments. And that's why I'm telling my brother that comparatively, because you must understand where you're coming from before you assess where you are. And where we're coming from shows that in 16 years, our president presented comparatively his budget in record time. In 16 years, despite the hoopla about padding, our budget came faster than most of the budgets.
So that you add this in your conversation. You said he presented his budget in record time.
Comparatively, yes.
But the others did not have issues with padding. So how would you now say, seeing that he says, because there were discrepancies.
You know why the others did not have
issues? The National Assembly was turned into a house of accountants and budget officers.
Interesting, Neta. That was why I gave you the information about the state house rent. Every budget before the 2016 budget was padded. Every budget in the history of this country. But you know why it didn't raise so much hoopla? They went with checks for the passing of the budget. They went with cash. Remember the Fabian Osuji situation? He was even taken to court for allegedly giving funds to the National Assembly people to pass the budget. We always had that. Now under the change regime, Mr. President did not go to the National Assembly with Ghana Must Go. So the National Assembly had to sit down to do what it must under the Constitution. Interestingly, as you and I talk, the National Assembly will not, I quote Dino Meleya at some point, he said this National Assembly will not be compromised to do what people want, which obviously means that previous National Assemblies were at some point compromised.
Okay.
As I talk, let me close this. Fundamentally, we have a change regime that was not ready to go to the National Assembly, to the hallowed chambers. We Ghana Must Go back to speedy budget processes. And interestingly, even without that, The pruning of the budget came, and the budget came out in record time, in 93
okay.
days.
All right, thank you.
Now,
You have 2 minutes.
No problem with that. But let me say this. When we are on national television, we are in a public domain. And we must be careful of statements about performance of people who are not in a situation that I am tonight to defend themselves. So I want to say that, I want to take that statement.
That individual.
Yeah, you know, I want to, because you are saying that there should be no sentiment. To make this argument interesting, because everything about Nigeria is about stamping out corruption. We want to stamp out corruption. We want good governance.
And the process
But
is
we
on.
Also want
and the process is
competent
on.
Leadership. My dear brother,
Mr. President,
excuse me, please.
And he's fighting corruption.
And I'll say this: whatever has happened between May and now about the performance of this administration, they will still need to do a lot of work in progress on competence and getting the right people in the right places. Let me give you an example, because you have gone this far. I will point out some things to you. The budgetary process must be handled by technical people, your own people. You have a minister of finance who is a chartered accountant, for crying aloud's sake. You also have people in the budget office. You have a minister of budget who, according to Mr. President, worked day and night and even lost weight. What was he doing for that budget to come out the day it came out? And then at the end of the day, even as the head of an organization, the change organization that you headed, my dear brother, if you do that and people who prepare your budget came up with a budget that is so error prone, with a lot of inconsistency, to the extent that even as budget is being passed, there are vital information that are still missing in this budget. And I'll tell you one thing. A budget is as good as it is faithfully implemented. And I'll tell you that when you are talking about implementation with this kind of budget that is already designed, so to say, to achieve minimal success.
That's absolutely.
The budget that we have right now is already a very, very, very error-prone budget, and
thank
it has
you.
Come.
Thank
and
you.
To show your inconsistency, you. No. They passed the budget in 92 days, according to you, without being given a budget.
93 days.
Thank you.
Yes. Now, let me say this. Fundamentally, you cannot run away from the fact that this regime is interested in creating new paradigms and new disposition with respect to accountability and responsible governance. And that's exactly what this, Mr. President, is doing. That is why those who were responsible at the level of the budget office for padding have been sent away. Mm-hmm. I do sincerely want to say that almost always it is easier to destroy a house than to rebuild. And as you and I talk, Mr. President is with us on that journey. He's leading the vehicle away from destructive tendencies, away from the jangling discord of poverty and disease to the amazing place of promise. Never have we had it this clear and this direct. And that's exactly why even the National Assembly has owned up to the fact that when they set out to work on the budget, they worked on a budget that cares about the Nigerian people. For the first time in the history of our country, we have a budget that provides for social securities and the likes. And for the first time in the history of our country, we have a budget that Mr. President is outrightly saying that I will implement based on the fundamentals of service to the people and service to the nation. And I do sincerely believe that, like I said, the National Assembly has owned up to the delay. And they're saying that in 2 weeks' time, they will present the details of the budget to Mr. President. That's exactly what we have to wait to see. Okay. And I believe that God the side of this country, we will remove from the jangling discord of poverty, disease, and despondency to the place of promise.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. We've been speaking with a development economist, Mr. Kola Ogunleye. Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you.
And Professor Chris Nwokabia Jr., Director General of Change Ambassadors of Nigeria. Thank you for coming.
My profound pleasure. God bless Nigeria.
And for you at home who allowed us to be a part of your evening, I want to say thank you so much. Those are sent in their comments, the ones you saw on the screen and the ones we couldn't say, take. We want to say thank you so much. Till we come your way again. Bye-bye.